disability income. What exactly is this? It replaces your lost income due to you having been in an accident or becoming too sick to work. Benefits are usually a percentage of whatever your actual income was at the time you became ill or injured. And there are exclusions that do apply, so always be sure to check exclusions because those things are not covered. Disability income policy periods. There's two of them. The first one is called the elimination period. You do not have coverage during the elimination period. You basically notify the company that you have a claim, and then you start that elimination period, that waiting period before your benefits kick in. The longer the elimination period, the longer you wait without benefits, the cheaper the premium, because the insurance company isn't paying you any benefits. So the longer you're willing to accept that total risk yourself, then the lower your premium would be. The other period is called the benefit period. Once you've gotten through the elimination period and the insurance company starts paying you your benefit, the longer the insurance company has to pay the benefit, maybe 2 years instead of 1 year, or 6 months instead of 9 months, something like that, the longer they have to pay you, the more expensive the premium will be because the insurance company has more out of pocket to pay those claims to you. Remember, there's no benefits for short-term disability, and these things are limited to a specific number of years or usually not longer than age 65. It's going to depend on the type of policy that you have. Disability income. Let's look at the difference between group and individual because there's always going to be some differences. For example, who pays the premium? On group, it's the employer. Sometimes the employees may contribute. It depends on how the plan is structured. If it's an individual policy, of course, you're going to pay the premium on your individual policy. The benefit amounts, they are based usually on a percentage of the worker's income. And on individual, it's just a flat amount of benefit that is determined. Short-term maximum periods on group, usually 13 to 26 weeks is considered short-term. 26 weeks is half of a year, 6 months. And then the individual short-term maximum periods are 6 months to 2 years. So there is a difference there. Remember that. And participation requirements. Under the group coverage, minimum number of employees or employees that are eligible, you have to meet those requirements or the plan wouldn't be effective. And they don't apply. Those types of participation requirements don't apply on an individual because you're the only one covered on an individual policy.